Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator, and welcome back to my ATS Let's Play series, Stories on the Road. Hope you guys are all doing well today, and hope you guys are having a happy holiday season, and I just want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas again. We're back here in the P389 today, finishing up our run over to Camp Verde, however you pronounce it, Arizona. We're just in Bakersfield, I should say. Took our 10-hour break. We're all rested up, good to go. Got driver fatigue simulation turned back on. Had it turned off because I was doing some testing on some stuff. Believe I have the whole shifting / transmission issue sorted out. It turns out it was the SKRS again, so I had to take it apart and fix that magnet again, just glued it back down. So hopefully that sticks for a couple weeks again, and we'll cross that bridge when we come to it again. But let's go ahead, get fired up here, and get back to work. And kill the truck to start. Yay! Still gotta mess around with that clutch sensitivity. And I'm just kind of interested to see what the game looks like in the daytime now, because I did adjust some of the Frosty mod settings myself. So I'm just kind of curious to see, kind of turn the bloom down in the daytime just a little bit. It was just a little bit strong for my personal liking. But we'll see how that looks today, I guess. And man, got a blind spot to pull out here. I don't think I see anything coming, so. But I will say, when this SKRS is working right, I absolutely love it. I mean, it just makes the game so much more fun. But when it's not working, it just creates all sorts of problems and headaches and frustration and all that good stuff. Made a little bit of progress on the 579 that I'm working on. Seen a couple of you guys comment that you were familiar with the YouTube channel and the dealership that I was talking about, so that's pretty cool. I know I've definitely been looking at it a little bit more here lately, just for kind of reference picks and things like that, so hopefully I can get that done here in the next week or so. So I'm kind of excited to start using that in some content. And don't get me wrong, I do like using different trucks here and there, but I do want to get one truck that I can just use and just kind of drive and drive and drive, put a ton of miles on it and things like that. At least make that particular content a little bit more realistic in that aspect. I've got to adjust that trailer brake sensitivity. And that thing stops like right now. For crying out loud. There we go. I do like the Gauge mod. It's by SW Mods, I believe. It's out on the Steam Workshop. Looks really cool. I just like the yellow gauges. Something different, kind of custom. and did look really good at night, that last video too. And I did see on SES's blog today that, that, you know, a little bit of a holiday greeting kind of thing, and a little bit of a YouTube video kind of teasing what's in store for 2017. And kind of what I gathered from it is, looks like maybe they're going to start releasing some heavy haul stuff in 2017 for both games. There we go. I'm sure that would make a ton of people happy. Set the cruise right about 60 and see what we can get away with there. But I know there's a lot of heavy haul fans out there in the community, like to spec their trucks out for that and do some custom loads and trailers and whatnot. Seen Trayscapes Trucking just released a heavy haul trailer the other day, which looks really good. I think it was Ivan's original one from back in the Holland days, but still a good mod nonetheless. He did a great job working with some folks to get that converted over. I do have it installed. I've not used it yet, but might be something I use early on next year. And from time to time, people ask me to do some heavy haul stuff. Just need to get a truck spec'd out pretty well for some heavy haul. Must still be fairly early in the morning, I'm guessing. Oh no, it's in the evening, okay. I thought after my 10-hour break it said it was like 8 o'clock in the morning or something. Guess I misread that. Because it is clearly the evening, which is fine. Which is absolutely fine. Do a fair share of day driving on the trail here anyway, so it's kinda nice to get that kinda nighttime. Kind of late in the day, early evening content in here as well. So I think it looks really good. What do we got? What do we got? Memorial Highway. Oh, it was a way station or something like that. Hopefully we get to go across a way station this run, because I just want to see what happens if we're overweight, if we get flagged for any kind of inspection or anything like that. Sky looks pretty amazing. Crap, that was my fault there. Dadgummit. That was all my fault right there. Oh, for Pete's sakes, man. First day on the job there, Chief. To drop out of from 8 high to 8 low and drop down in the other range like a noob. That's why we can't have nice things. That is why we can't have nice things. Thank you. We're going to get too wound up there. That cop being right up there in front of us. Okay, that's something I've not noticed before is the no passing zones. I don't know if that's something new or just something I never noticed before, but that's pretty cool how they have that. You know, especially with how aggressive the AI is now in passing you. Because they are for sure a little bit more aggressive or a little bit more impatient or whatever. I've said it before, but I'll say it again and probably say it numerous more times. I really do like the new road systems in the game now. You know, how they've updated some of these overpasses and exits and things like this. Just make it a lot more fun. Adds a little bit of depth to the game. Getting there. We're getting there. We might get there this episode. Who knows? This could be in a three-parter. Set a cruiser right around 57, 58. Be a little bit safer, I guess. Not 56, we should definitely be fine with that. Should definitely be fine with that, no worries about getting tickets or anything. Does that though. They just kind of slow down what seems like out of nowhere. Hopefully no exits or anything like that come up here in the next couple seconds. speed up a little bit just to get around traffic here. That way I don't get stranded out in the left-hand lane. Think of an exit or a way station or something like that pops up. See an interesting conversation going on over on the SES forums the other day about it was on the Mega Wishlist thread about someone had mentioned something about it'd be cool if when you pass a truck if they flash your lights to let you know that you're clear to pass. I think I've talked a little bit about that in the past as well as a couple others. That would be a pretty cool feature. You know, maybe once you're so far away. You know, the AI would automatically flash you to let you know it's clear to come over. There we go. There's our way station. I'm sure it'd be kind of hard to code something like that in the game, but still it'd be pretty cool. Truth is upon us. Are we going to get flagged to pull around back? Are we getting a ticket? Or are they just going to let us go about our merry way? Oh, nope, just let us go about our way. That's kind of curious. Workshop, I think it's like 6 1/4 cat. Sing everyone the song of my people. Yep, knew that was coming. Knew that was coming. That's all right though. This thing's an absolute beast. Thing's just chewing this hill up. I don't know, I just love coasting down these hills though with the Jake brake on though. Sounds so cool. Here. speed again. That's what I'm talking about. Dang it. Didn't even know he was back there. There he goes. I was having fun there. Wasn't paying attention to speed too much. Doing good on fuel, so I ain't gonna worry about stopping. We're all rested up. At least we should still be fairly rested up. Guy's icon there started getting the blue a little bit, but nothing to worry about quite yet, I don't think. Oh, what the heck? I thought it told me that I needed to get off at that exit. Not so much, I guess. Either way, after that, still kind of bugged. Because I know a couple of people said during the beta that it would, randomly do stuff like this. Or run you through a rest area that you absolutely didn't need to go through. Because, damn it. Listen to that straight pipe. This sounds mean. Well, this has been an interesting run to say the least. Let's see how close we are now. We're not too far out. Coming up on Kingman. So this may or may not end up being a three-parter. It's going to be close. Going back to that SES holiday greetings teaser video, it'd be kind of cool if there was a Freightliner Cascadia in that big box. I'm just kind of throwing that out there. Just throwing that out there, guys. Trailer that is. I don't know if that's part of the Jazzy Cat pack. I did see there was an update to that, so I gotta get that installed. I don't imagine now that 1.5 has been live for just a little while, but you should start seeing some updates to a lot of the mods, getting them compatible with 1.5. And there's a couple I gotta get updated. Want to get the Wabash National updated so that's not giving off that red material error. through Kingman. Now, if you look at him, he's not doing too bad, averaging 5 miles a gallon. I'd say that's too bad for a big old cat like this and 50,000 pounds of beef behind us. Bump up the cruise control just a little bit there. Overall, not too bad of a run there. Just a couple hiccups here and there, but nothing too serious. Looks like the little sleep icon there is a little over half, so I imagine it won't be too much longer. This guy's going to start yawning. Gotta be one of my, if not my most favorite engine sound in the game though. I think it just sounds awesome. I seen earlier though, I really like how these gauges look at night. This looks really cool. Another trip icon bumped up a little bit. Looks like we're coming up on the destination here pretty soon. Thank you. what I wanted. Oops. Whoops. Let's see how close we are. We're just about there. And we'll get her finished up this run for sure. Oh, show. Closing in. Imagine if you've seen the icon there on the hub here any second. Yeah, there it is. Kind of see it there in the top left hand corner. Be on the beaten path wherever it is. Even though I saw it there on the mini map, it kind of snuck up on me there. Anyway. Alright. That shouldn't be too bad. They want it inside the barn, or... looks like they went inside the barn. That still shouldn't be too bad. Just get whipped around here and back it on in. Think I can make it through the barn there with that trailer there, but it's alright. Can he do it in one shot? I screwed it up already. Can he save it? Seriously? Foot is still on the clutch. So we got the side of the barn there. Adjust side mirror out just a little bit. There we go. That is just way too freaking touchy. We'll take it. Eh, not too bad. It's about as good as I can do. It's just kind of weird that they got that little farm trailer back there where it is. Alright guys, that's going to wrap it up for this episode of Stories from the Road. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. But guys, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing ya.